fans inside your computer probably look something like this, or this, or maybe this. But what they don't look like is this. That is, unless you happen to have a Meshless AIO by Meshless Design, a case that, contrary to its name, does in fact contain some mesh. But the mesh, or lack thereof, is not what drew us in. It was MD's claim that round fans are a sickness and our long fan is the cure. Really though, guys? A 14900K and an RTX 4090 in this case with no other fans, not even on the radiator?
I'm skeptical.
And so is our sponsor, Nexigo. Whether you're in need of webcams or accessories for your VR device, Nexigo has a great selection of products to choose from. Check out their giveaway at the link down below. Crossflow cooling fans have been used in gaming PCs before. Creative modders have used them to cram water cooling where no water cooling was intended to go, and the Silverstone FX121 was available as an optional accessory for their first generation compact case, the SG01, way back in 2005. So then, where has this technology been all of my life? Hiding in plain sight, it turns out. Crossflow fans are favored for their compact size, even airflow distribution, and low noise, and can be found in everything from household fans, to air conditioners, to gas fireplaces, to computers, apparently, that also have seatbelts in them.
Yeah, but to really see how cool it is, we have to get inside. So
okay.
Let's take off these panels.
Ooh, that is a tight fit. Good gravy. Promise you it's not cheap. We'll get to that later. How does this side come on?
It doesn't.
Oh.
The rest of this is all like one connected piece of metal.
No.
Yeah.
It totally is. Did they extrude this entire piece?
Yes!
Like, that's amazing. Like, how are you like this? Wow. You're just so cool. Wow.
Sorry.
Is he even famous anymore? To be clear, there are some screwed on pieces. The power supply mount right here, this angled SSD mount that's made out of, I think, metal. That's fun. The optional carrying handle and what appears to be an adapter for the top that allows you to mount conventional fans if you really want.
Not quite. That's for the radiator for your AIO.
Oh! I get it. Your motherboard goes here, there's a little clip and a routing path for your tubes over here, and then you've got this one fan that blows air out the top of the radiator?
No, it actually pulls through the radiator and blows all out the side right here.
Oh, one fan to rule them all.
Except for this guy.
Oh, presumably it's for RAM. Not for sheep, only RAM.
That was a bad joke.
I don't know, I think it was the goat.
You kid.
Ah, I'm defeated.
So let's shepherd this away from the puns and back towards the case.
Yeah, otherwise we might not be able to keep the viewers hooked.
Ooh, a shepherd's hook, I like it.
And there it is. Custom crossflow fan. Apparently the manufacturer is not just sourcing these from AliExpress or whatever, but rather they've sourced a motor, an impeller, and put together an assembly that they think offers a unique value proposition for cooling, well, your entire system with just this. This is cool. I don't think I've ever seen a small form factor sandwich style case before that fits a quad slot GPU. Is this a 4090?
Actually, they claim that this case was specifically designed for 4090s and i9 core processors. Like, absolutely crazy specs. You are putting the GPU in upside down.
Oh. Yes, I certainly am. Really?
Yeah, it's okay. This is the first of many wacky mechanisms in here.
Ah, GPU installation bracket, I see.
I don't know what that's for.
I thought you said there was an airflow guide.
That must be what it is. It must be, yes, I saw that as an option on their website, but I didn't realize that that's what it was at the time, because when I built this and tested it, we did not use it. I don't know where it goes, and I couldn't figure it out, so I just didn't put it in.
Okay, fair enough.
They're working on manuals right now. They're in the process of making it. They sent us some early versions, but it's all like lorem ipsum stuff right now.
GPU bracket. Is that what it was? Oh, good.
What?
You just gotta get some screws on there.
That's pretty clever. It allows you to just screw your standard screws into this, and then something.
Yeah,
that's neat. I'll put the screws in.
Sounds good.
Is that an 1100 watt power supply?
Mm-hmm.
Dang.
I feel like we do this every time we bring this out. We're always like, holy crap, there's 1100 watts in there. And before I put this in, I'm going to put the cables on.
What is this for?
This is one of our many quirks. We have our GPU support bracket that just kind of like sits in there. It kind of fits between the case and the fan.
Uh-huh. And then it just kind of sits
yeah.
on there?
Just, it's okay. Really weird.
Okay, sure.
Fun fact, we can actually screw this into this one.
Oh. Well, that's cool.
Want to see quirk number two?
I guess. I haven't even put the GPU in yet,
they
though.
They give you custom length cables.
Oh, well, that's cool.
Yeah.
Is that just for reviewers, or is that a thing?
That's you ask for the kind that you want with the case.
Oh, wonderful.
Yeah, and they're super flexible. Do you know why they aren't all this flexible? Is
yes.
it like a safety thing?
Because the silicone covers are more expensive. I know this because okay. we're going to be making our own cables, and we're going to be using really, really soft silicone covers.
Yeah, because these are nice.
Yeah.
They're so nice to work with.
LTTstore.com at some point, yeah. All right, I think I figured out how to get the GPU connector plugged in.
Yeah, sure. Actually, there's a smarter way.
Oh.
If you look at the bottom of the case, there's panels.
Oh, look at that. You can just open that up and then you can plug it in. Well, I didn't do that.
Well, you're going to have some problems in a moment, but I'll let you discover those on your own.
Yeah, I need this to go in.
You should go from the other side.
Oh.
You made this so much harder for yourself. Yeah, no, just give up.
No, I can do it.
No, stop.
No, I can do it.
No, because you got to hook it on.
It's going to make it.
No.
It's the little engine that could. The little GPU that could go in this way.
You mad, bro?
A little, but like not mad that you did it. I'm just mad that you refused to do it the right way.
So you're mad that it worked.
No.
Oh no, does that have to, oh. Do I have to slide it all the way out this way now in order to latch it onto a thing?
Yep. I was telling you, dude.
I maintain that my way still worked. Ooh, that's cool. Look where the bracket mounts onto.
Have you noticed the doohickey?
Super cool. Wait, a doohickey? I noticed this. Whoa, and there's a doohickey.
So, because of how tight it is to get it in, that allows you to disconnect the PCIe slot.
Oh, no way.
So fun to spin. It goes.
Okay. How about it goes in the computer?
Yeah. All right, how about you put that in there?
Yeah, okay. Dude, did you get this in here with this GPU before?
Yep.
It's not even close.
What have you done?
I have done nothing. I have broken nothing.
They just need a little bit more sag.
I hate that that's the solution. To their credit, it's not that hard to build in, though.
It's surprisingly easy.
Power supply bracket just goes in, a little something like that.
And we're about to get our motherboard in, and then we're almost there.
Wow. I realize now we haven't really talked about the rest of the specs of this build at all.
Oh, yeah. Well, we got a 7950X, so not quite i9 territory in terms of thermal output, but...
A lot.
A lot of thermal output. We got 32 gigs of DDR6000 RAM.
Okay.
Tier 5 6000 RAM.
And did we throw a PCIe Gen 5 M.2 in here, just for good measure?
I'm not sure what the M.2 is in there.
Nice.
It's one of our standard, I think it's a 990 Pro, it's a lab standard one.
Nice. And now it's, not going anywhere because the screws are in the standoffs.
And now we get to see yet another fun quirk of this case.
Well, how am I supposed to screw these in?
May I introduce you to a tiny screwdriver?
Wait.
They even have a little notch.
Shut up. This comes out, and I do that.
From the all metal construction to like all of these weird unique bits, you can kind of see the costs adding up.
We'll get to that.
Yeah.
Later. Now I just gotta run the CPU power connector, which conveniently goes right here. Look at that.
And I can put in our AIO.
Oh yeah.
Something interesting.
So no fans.
No fans at all. You don't
wow.
even have space for them.
It's like me in August.
No fan? Why don't you have fans in August?
Last August.
I was thinking like house fans, and I was like, dude, that's the hottest time of the year. Interesting thing to note about this case is that currently it only accepts 280 millimeter radiators, which is why we went with a white one, because we don't have another black one currently.
No, that's an aesthetic choice. That's valid. Is there a reason this is not going in?
Yeah, the pipes don't want to. You really got to put them in there. They're really bent.
Ooh,
I'll let you do your thing. I'm gonna come over here and install the 24 pin. There we go. Wow, that's tight.
Yep.
Good gravy.
Even to the side panel, it's tight.
Very delicious gravy. Wait, did we put thermal compound on?
Did you?
I didn't.
Yeah. That's a lot of goop.
Yeah, you managed to not goop the part that you tried to goop. Yeah, that's good. No, that's good. Okay. Oh, geez, do you not wipe when you're finishing?
Oh, sorry.
Hey, that's it, folks. It's all in. This didn't take that long.
No.
Wait, the strap.
That just slides in on top.
Oh.
Just go on the other side.
Look at that. You can just wave the whole thing around
like that.
Okay,
that's enough of that. That's a lot of money there.
I can't believe how painless this build was.
Yeah, they've put in a lot of thought as to how to put it together. And they also actually have like really, really nicely done build videos to show you as an instructions.
Which we didn't even look at.
No, we didn't need to.
And man, it blows. Oh yeah, I want to see the crossflow fan. Ooh, it does move.
Yeah.
Wow, and that's interesting. I don't know whether they've got any kind of ducting on it or anything, but it doesn't blow straight. I can't feel it at all here. I feel it here. So when that hot air is coming out of your system, it's not coming out somewhere where these fans on the GPU are just gonna suck it right back in. It's going away.
Yeah.
That is super cool. Let's hear this fan spin up. I need to feel this. She moves though.
She really does. It's a lot of air.
You could probably see my arm hair blowing in the wind here. That's quite the thing. Oh my God, you're gonna hit the GPU now too.
Yeah, why not?
I mean, sure.
We actually have headroom on our CPU right now. That won't last forever. I wanna hit it with combustor first.
Fine.
Because one of the things we'll notice is that it'll prevent our CPU from getting hotter. It's really good at throwing air out of the case in general.
Something I'm noticing here is because we're using PWM control for the fan, that means that the hotter the CPU goes, the faster the fan spins. Well, the GPU doesn't affect it. And as long as our GPU stays cool enough, which it looks like we're gonna level out around 65 to 70 degrees.
Yeah. I mean,
it's not that loud.
It's a four slot 4090. It's gonna be fine. If it was a thinner 4090, I would have more concerns about it.
I mean, even then, not necessarily. I've seen small form factor designs where the exhaust is basically just kind of getting sucked back in and recycled, even though it is being thrown out into the room. And you can kind of stand near the computer and go, oh yeah, this is the hot zone, heat dome, right?
Yeah.
But this thing, it's at 550 watts and it's just hucking the heat away.
Let's crank them both, let's go.
Okay. 800 watts.
The number I'm most interested in is our liquid temp, because our Ryzen CPUs are gonna boost all the way up to 95 just by how they're designed. So it's tough to tell how hot it's actually getting. Seeing our liquid temp going up over there is kind of giving us a better idea. When we were idle CPU, it was like 26 degrees. We've seen it climb to 30 over the course of like a minute maybe.
And I've also found a bit of a flaw in the design of this carrying strap. It tends to get sucked down onto the rad, which is a good indication that it's pulling a lot of air into it, but is giving up some of our surface area to strappage. Oh,
yeah.
There it is. CPU clock speed is going down as the liquid temperature goes up. Our GPU is fine.
Yeah.
That's rock solid.
Don't need to worry about
it. Is this
it
made
at all.
By ASUS? Because it's heart touching. Remember their old slogan, rock solid, heart touching?
No, I don't.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. You know, it's loud, but it's a pretty broad spectrum noise.
It's very tolerable.
Yeah.
It's like a white noise machine.
It's not whiny at all.
Yeah. And if you were to have like a bunch of like 40 millimeter fans or even 120 fans, you're usually gonna get more noise than this.
No.
Even right up against mesh. Have you heard of Fractal Terra with fans right up against it? It's bad.
The performance of any thermal solution comes down to three main elements: airflow, static pressure, and sound. Airflow refers to how much air can be moved without any restriction. Static pressure refers to the ability of a cooling solution to overcome obstructions like radiators and dust filters. And sound is obvious, how loud it is. Of course, this casual onset test isn't enough to draw a real conclusion. So we had the labs team test the case at the low, medium, and high presets before the button broke.
In combustor, we see our GPU. Like we saw here, totally
fine. Across the board.
It doesn't get that hot.
But the CPU really wants that high preset.
And even then.
It stays, it's at 40, it's at 48.
Actually, no, then it's good.
Yeah.
But it does need to max out.
Yeah, and you can see, like, even with a 15-minute test, we still had a little bit of climbing to do. It's not quite flat.
And in the acoustic tests, yeah, it reaches as high as 54 decibels from the left side, where most people would be positioned. But like we said before, subjectively, the quality of that noise is not that bad.
And if you're not running all core loads, you don't ever really need to have it run that fast.
No, I mean, if you're gaming, you're not going to see anywhere near that.
Yeah.
So, in summary then, crossflow fans are fine, which doesn't answer the question of why they aren't more common. Well, one reason is that their best quality is their compactness. If you had components spread out laterally, a crossflow fan takes up minimal space in two of its three dimensions and creates a laminar airflow stream across its entire length, ensuring that everything ends up evenly cooled. Only problem is that makes them kind of irrelevant for tower style PCs. So I guess that answers that question. But in theory, they should be great for servers then. So why isn't that a thing? To answer that, we need to talk about the downsides. Servers need minimal downtime, and having five small axial fans instead of one big crossflow means that one or more of those little fans can die without losing all of the cooling capacity of your server. This gives the administrator time to install a replacement. Of course, that could be overcome if it wasn't for some of the other issues that we've tiptoed around until now. In addition to our original three factors, there's money and nicheness. Crossflow fans, being less common and more complex, tend to fail more often and tend to cost more than typical PC cooling fans, not to mention it can be harder to find replacements. And in an industry where every penny counts and standardization drives prices down, well, the cheaper, standard solution is going to be the one that wins. Anywho, are we finally going to talk about the price of this thing?
Yeah, it's expensive. $360 US is the price.
And that's just for the case.
Yeah, that's not including some of the extras that we got, like the handle and stuff.
I see.
To be fair, they're a really small operation, just a few people. It's a small run of a case. It's all metal, incredible premium build.
That's true.
And
I got no problem with any of that.
And really weird. Just doing something different and non-standard means that they're gonna have to come up with all sorts of solutions to manufacture it, which is gonna drive up the price further. The fans are expensive. Compared to like a $6 whatever fan for a normal computer, you have to spend like, what did we say, like $30 minimum?
They were in the range of like $20 to $30 starting price.
Yes, yeah, that's for the manufacturer, not for the end consumer. So like the whole thing is just expensive, but it's also really, really cool.
But that's not the same thing as overpriced, because there's a justification for why it costs so much. Just like I justified the price of this Segway to our sponsor.
Paperlike. If you're looking for a screen protector for your iPad, Paperlike has got you covered. The Paperlike 2.1 is manufactured in Switzerland, so you know it's good, and is designed to help you write and draw on your iPad just like how you would on paper, but without annoying bugs like real paper. It uses their exclusive microbead technology called nanodots to emulate the stroke resistance of paper without sacrificing on screen clarity. Make sure to check out Paperlike at the link below so you can write right, baby. That's a W and an R. You see what I did there?
If you guys enjoyed this video, why don't you check out the last time Adam and I built a computer together?
I don't know what that was. There's another small computer that was frustrating.
Yeah.
Let's see how it is.